Hello and welcome back, everybody. We find ourselves once again within the prison architect. Phoenix has made a lot of sweeping changes to the prison that I'm really interested in, some of which I'm also a bit confused about, but we'll get to those in time. Suffice it to say, we've got this whole new line of cell blocks going on that have taken on a new design than what we had originally created over here. On these new cell blocks, there's a 2x2 hallway in the middle, in between the cell blocks, which I suppose could work, but I honestly thought it was fine just to have the vertical hallways through the actual cell blocks themselves. I'm not quite sure what's going on with that, but we can see it through. The big issue that they have currently is a decisive lack of utilities, which I intend to fix. Let's see if we can pull this on over there, as well as bring the electronics right on through the hallway, which should power pretty much everything up as soon as they're done with that. As I was talking about last episode, the laundry we have is kind of small for the current number of prisoners we have, so it's time to finally convert this old holding cell into a proper laundry, as well as clear out what I suspect was a just few remnants of the common room that had been here. And since I'm doing that, I might as well de-designate the room and turn it into a full-time kitchen, since I think that's the intention of removing the walls, but I'm not quite sure. It'd be silly to have prisoners going there just to play with nothing, so it's better just to convert the room and worry about its exactness a little bit later. I think there's also a few problems with this cell block here. It happens when you run out of money and are using the clone tool, is that sometimes certain parts of the build don't populate, so we're just going to have to drag that on over. As you can see by our money, we just got the cell block grant, which grabbed us that extra 20,000 in cash, which is going to be instrumental in setting ourselves up for the future a bit. So right off the bat, before I do anything frivolous, I want to increase the number of saws we have in the workshop, and I'm going to create a forestry project to give our prison a little bit of sustainable income. So right around here and down should be good enough. There we go. And might as well include this upper area as well, just to keep it a nice constant distance away from the building itself. Depending upon where the tree stumps actually populate, I'm going to build paths down into it so that the workers can quickly harvest the trees come their fruition. But for now, I want to see where exactly they all populate so I don't run over any trees with them. Looks like this is going to be a straight shot down, and another line of paving stones all the way up. That should provide for our workers to have a very quick in and out route to gather up all the trees and plant them once we begin that. And all those changes already cost us about half of our grant, so we're going to want to be looking as to how we can spend the rest of that a little bit more wisely. Still a few utility problems with these new cells, which can be easily worked out, but now that we've got our capacity over 100, it's definitely time to, first off, refine some of our programs, but also open up the prison to more inmates, because we really could use a lot of extra income right now. It shows that it's pretty high, but a lot of that's from exports, and so the more prisoners we can get in here, the better. Something else that I noticed is that we still are running into a bit of a guard problem, in that we don't quite have enough to do anything, and I think there were some issues with deployment, given the new cell blocks, so let me just have a look-see. At night, there we go. At night, that's about right. I actually want them out of the classroom at night, out of that canteen, the workshop, the common room. Oh, what's going on? There was a fight in the classroom. What a scummy thing to do. Let's grab a doctor. No, they'll take care of it on their own. That's something that's I've been noticing lately, is that the prison actually takes care of injuries a lot better than it used to. I think the utilities is the main priority for this instant. Oh my goodness! What? How did this happen? Nobody's died, though. Okay. That's good. Let's keep that up. Just send a bunch of guards in there. And I also want to grab a doctor or two specifically, because right now we absolutely need them down there to start working on these casualties. I don't know what incited this horrible insurrection, but I think we've got it under control just because we have an overwhelming number of guards in there. But good grief, that was frightening. Luckily, our doctors are tending the wounded, which means no one's gonna go without injuries, without treatment for their injuries for too long, and we're gonna have this under control. But that was really strange. I think that if we're gonna have that many people working in the cleaning cupboard, we need to add a deployment for that. During nighttime, it can go away, but during the daytime, we're gonna want someone in there just in case. Well, maybe not during daytime, maybe just during work time. That sounds like a better idea. During mealtime, we don't need anybody in the classroom. Extras in the canteen, you can stay out of the common room. One in the kitchen's fine. And just the regular deployment is a-okay with me. During work time, we do want an extra guards in the workshop and classroom, as well as the laundry? No, the kitchen. There we go. And I think that should be about right. We don't need extras. In fact, we don't need anybody in the classroom during just regular free time, but one in the yard sounds like a good idea, especially down here next to that cleaning cupboard, which apparently was a big issue. Something that I'm noticing is that while our prison is pretty set up to handle a large number of inmates, it's less able to handle a large number of insurrecting inmates. We only have 5 solitary cells, which is just not cutting the mustard anymore, so I think that it's about time to create another facility for managing them. And so I think that instead of an indoor solitary confinement system like we have up here near the laundry, I think that it's about time we made an outdoor solitary system right off the yard here. That way it's a lot cheaper to create, and we can fill it up, and the fences are very cheap, so it's just really quick and easy, over and done with in just a matter of moments. I can set this all up and have it pretty much ready to function as soon as I could want. All I'm gonna be including is toilets, since it's a pretty bare bones setup, but I shouldn't need anything more than that. And yeah, another set of solitary cells in the middle works for me. That should be ideal. And we can set it up so that we have the solitary doors on different sides, depending. I guess we'll just fit doors in to make it work. Do we have enough cash? Ugh, these are really expensive. So let's go with regular jail doors. We don't actually need solitary confinement doors in order to turn these into solitary confinement cells. But, oh, a little bit silly. Okay, here's the new plan. Oh dear. Okay, fine. We'll just leave it at that. It's not going to be perfectly symmetrical, but if we're really worried about that, we can fix it some other time. Right now, it's just imperative that we get all these down and designated. In fact, I don't even think I'm going to give them toilets, since we don't really have the cash for that right now. I want to save some sort of buffer for little odds and ends here and there. Technically, no. That was definitely an incident. I don't know what was going on there. Have I still not set up the utilities in here? Let's get that fixed up. We don't want any prisoners having us stay in cells that don't have the proper utilities to take care of them. That could be just a recipe for disaster. And clearly, we're already having troubles with our inmates not quite feeling like their needs are being met. So I want to be extra careful in the future that we're making sure that no matter what, we've got all of our needs met. Looks like it's kind of dirty in there, but that's no problem. I think we run a shakedown right now since most of our prisoners are in bed and we're kind of having a problem with contraband, if I remember correctly. I remember Phoenix said something along those lines, so yeah, this is an incredible supply of all sorts of bad things. Luckily, there's no demand for weapons, which means that we're pretty much in the safe when it comes to prisoners starting riots and fighting against each other, but that only is going to last so long. I also noticed that the white tiles in the shower aren't perfect, so I want to fix that up, as well as put some in for this top shower, because if this is going to be my template, I want them to have the shower components wherever they could need them. This guard is going to be sent over here just to get these two workers in to clear up the tunnels, and now it can be done. What are our workers actually doing at the moment? Our single gardener, all lonely, is trying to plant all these trees by himself. Let's give him a helping hand. Do we really need to search the trees? I don't think we do. Let's demolish this jail door. And we can now designate all of these as secure solitary cells from the menu here. Right, like so. Boom. Boom. Now we should be able to better accommodate the 31. Oh, Lord. We are running a criminal den here. It's almost like it's a prison for convicts. Yes, almost. But yeah, there's a whole lot of problems we're having. Luckily, we have some plenty of free guards available to escort them all to the lovely new set of solitary confinement we have. And I think that, yeah, concrete tiles. No, paving stone. Paving stone would probably look better here, since most of this is going to be regularly traversed, and I don't want any sort of flooring inside the solitary cells. What's going on here? Surrounded by walls and a door. Okay, fine. I will add in that one single fence piece you're looking for. That'll make you happy. As well as materials. We're going to want to put paving stones in all the doors as well, just to make it kind of transition nicely into the dirt floor cells. I didn't include any sorts of toilets because I don't want to have them tunneling anywhere while they're in solitary. Not that they can do that, but I have a sneaking suspicion that they could find a way, and I don't want to deal with that. He's just kind of waiting around in his unenclosed solitary cell, but even with all these extra solitary cells, we still don't have enough capacity to meet the need of all of these horrible criminals that need to be punished for their wrongdoings in bringing contraband into my prison. So let's have a look-see. Yeah, the supply went way down, which did increase the demand slightly, especially for weapons, which is scary, but we should be able to have a better grasp on that in the future. Looks like we're doing really nicely on power at all of our power plants. If anything, this is both the one in the bottom left and the top right are a bit over-serviced with capacitors, while this one is approaching its limit, but I think that's not too important. So long as everything has a nice buffer to accept a few fluctuations, we should be okay going forward. I noticed that we've got a pair of... Ooh, dear. You see, this is why you include like 5 or 6 guards in the canteen during regular eating hours, because they will fight you one. Oh, look at that guard dog doing its duty. Searching all those nasty inmates. Speaking of guard dogs, I'm going to want to also change up their deployment because due to this new cell block, we need to extend the patrols a little bit in order to accommodate. So, you know, I don't even know if that's an option. I think the better, or at least easier solution, is to get a pair of new dogs, which we have the kennels for, that's good. It's gonna cost us most of the rest of our money, cutting us down to almost nothing with just over, or just under $1,000 left to deal with incidentals here and there, but shouldn't be too much of an issue. We've got an injured prisoner that's not being taken care of, so let's get someone working on that. We can leave the guard dog injured. It's not going to be too much of a problem. But now that I have those extra guard dog I can deploy them to help out with the prison. Let's get a little bit zoomed in so we can see exactly where we want this. Okay. The dog patrol needs to go around the solitary just because I always want to be checking the perimeter. Doesn't matter if they're making tunnels inside the prison. We need people, specifically dogs, to be on the perimeter checking, making sure that nobody is actually going to be getting out. Bring that all over, and I can delete this inner patrol. I want to put at least one dog here. Okay, so it looks like we actually have one continuous patrol around the entire prison, so I'm actually going to divide that into four semi-equivalent sections. One, and we're gonna have this second one, this third one, and that fourth one. So during the night, we should have all four of those patrols regularly traversed by all of our guard dogs. We can add another guard dog to both the infirmary and, not the infirmary, but the workshop and kitchen. During eating hours, we can double the patrols of the dogs. Do we want to add another one that goes down the rows or through the tables? I don't think we do. I think we just focus on the main areas. And during regular time, not doubling up on the kitchen. We can just have one in the yard and another just to kind of wander randomly and assign their own tasks. I am going to have to delete that from the secondary patrols patterns just because of how the blank spaces work, but aside from that, we're pretty much good. Oh, that's another thing. I did clear out this old holding cell because I wanted to convert it into a laundry room, but looking at my money, that's actually not very feasible, so I think I'm going to pass on that. Let me just double check my deployment, because he was hanging out in the shower a bit. I wanted to make sure nothing funky was going on with that, but no, he seems to be doing his job quite diligently. Is he just waiting for lockdown? Can we not escort him to his cell or something? Why do we only have three guards available? Okay, we've got two resting. Three resting, that's... Goodness, 26 stationed, really? What hour is it? It's 4 to 5, which is work. And we have several extras. Since they're at work, we can empty out the canteen. Definitely want to keep the one in the cleaning cupboard. We don't need one in the common room. During work hours, yeah, we should still have the airlock and delivery section manned at all times, but I think that's the most we can safely cut, so we really just have to rely on our guards to not be taking their break during work time, since that's a especially sensitive time to have guards out of commission, since there is a quite high likelihood of riots, like, not necessarily riots, but at least large-scale brawls like we had in the cleaning cupboard. I think that everybody's finally done with all of their solitary confinements from the shakedown, which is nice. We've got 8 extra prisoners coming in to fill the void. We're getting a little bit of extra money, but the amount we're spending is pretty high, so we're not getting a whole lot, especially since the imports haven't really set anything not the imports, but the exports haven't set anything out today, or at least not much, which is a real problem. But in order to fix that, the best idea is to increase the number of people actually taking the workshop safety induction. I could spend more on pharmacological treatments in order to get some of them channeling through, but it's very expensive for not a whole lot of payoff, so instead I'm going to just start a single kitchen safety and hygiene routine and get a few more people working in there. We seem to have plenty of room and space for the kitchen to function pretty consistently to supply this canteen. I'm slightly worried that there's not quite enough space for 100 plus prisoners, but that's not too big of an issue right now, at least, because we don't have quite that much, and everyone seems to mill about and sit down quite happily with the amount of space that's currently available. But I think that the prison's in a nice space. We've got a little bit of extra cash, and I think that this is time to pass it right back on over to Phoenix. We created a new solitary section. We spruced up a bunch of the places. We finally connected all these utilities over here, including these two cameras just now. And overall, just a bunch of little management details while we wait for more cash, specifically from this new forestry area. So thank you all so much for watching. It's always a pleasure, and I look forward to seeing what sort of new shenanigans Phoenix can get up to in the next episode. Have a great day, everybody.